Hey, what's up guys, it's Renaldo here. So this video is going to focus on the US ambassador to South Africa, Lana Marks. Now she was appointed in October of 2019 to become the ambassador to South Africa on behalf of the United States. And it seems that she really does not have a cooking clue as to what's going on in South Africa. The reason I say this is because she did a couple of things recently which really makes me question whether or not she understands South Africa. The first thing she did was put out a tweet on Martin Luther King Day talking about South Africa, and you can see this here. As you can see here, she says that nowhere has Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s legacy been more visible than in the transformation of South Africa into a vibrant democracy. I consider it a privilege to be here and I hope my work will always be a testament to his memory. Yeah, so if you know anything about Dr. Martin Luther King's speech and his vision for society, you would understand that he didn't want 59 murders a day in a country, 114 rapes every single day, policies in government that discriminates against people based on their race, quotas in sport, and various other different things that divides a democracy. Because yes, even though South Africa became a democracy in 1994, and how that was a glorious moment for South Africa, 25 years later, we can't look back and say that things are vibrant in South Africa. With the current problems we are facing, it's quite clear that it's actually the opposite of being vibrant. Now with that being said, this is small fry. This tweet is but one thing that made the alarm bells go off. What really is problematic is her interview on Kyknet with Waldemar Pelser, because there she said some insane things with regards to South Africa and also her blind loyalty and support to Cyril Ramaphosa and the ANC government in South Africa. So what I'm going to do is play you some of the snippets of this interview, and then I'm going to interject in between each one to make a point. So with that being said, here we go.
You have said that you have much faith in President Ramaphosa's reform agenda. Why do you say that you have faith?
I think that he won in a democratic process. I think he surrounded himself with a core of terrific ministers, and I think that augurs well for the future.
Yeah, so do you see what I mean? Clearly, Lana Marks is uninformed. She is now making statements that I'm pretty sure she has no idea what she's talking about. Because firstly, she's saying all is well for the future of South Africa, which clearly isn't the case. We're facing junk status in this country. We experience stage 6 load shedding. The SOEs are crumbling. We're over $3 trillion in debt as it stands right now. But yes, she is saying that all is well. And then added to this, she praises Cyril surrounding himself with the ministers that he did. Well, South Africans know that many of these ministers are really questionable and are dodgy characters.
What needs to change here for American investors to truly rush in?
Well, I believe that in the future, South Africa will rise to one of the major trading partners of the United States. It's number 39 now, and I intend to bring South Africa into the top 20 and to be the number one. There are a couple of acrimonious issues on the table at the moment. However, everything that's going on at the moment is being dealt with in the most transparent manner with the Ramaphosa administration. So we're comfortable with that at the moment.
Yeah, so another confusing statement. I don't see how we can improve as a trading partner when we go into junk status and we don't really have stuff to offer the United States. So what exactly, other than gold and diamonds, are we going to trade? Because we are already trading that with the United States. And then she goes on to say that there are some issues that obviously we need to deal with, but she is very optimistic for the future. Now, Waldemar actually came in and called out her bullshit right here by asking her, you know, can you mention some of these issues? And have a listen to what she said.
Can you give us an example or two of these acrimonious issues which you hope will be addressed?
You know them all, so it's not necessary for me to outline them.
Ding, 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 ding. Alarm bells ringing. She clearly does not know what those issues are. As soon as you have to say, you know what they are, I'm not going to waste your time by explaining it, then clearly you do not know what you are talking about.
But our government does understand, surely, that this remains true only as long as we play ball, right? And we don't meddle too much with property rights.
Everything is being dealt with in a very transparent manner by this administration. to our satisfaction.
This answer by her that everything is being dealt with in a transparent manner is absolute bullshit. The only thing you need to do is look at the proposed EWC bill and the National Health Insurance bill, and you will see that the ANC don't actually listen to what the public has to say. There were hundreds of thousands of submissions by people on both these policies that have just been flatly ignored, and there's no responses given to the public with regards to this. And then added to all of this is the fact that with the EWC policy, the ANC just took a U-turn. Because firstly, they wanted the courts to decide whether compensation is needed, and they've just changed the bill before it goes to Parliament and said, no, well, in actual fact, it needs to be the President and his cabinet that needs to decide whether or not there's compensation needed. So there's absolutely nothing transparent with how Cyril Ramaphosa and his government is currently dealing with issues in South Africa.
Have you met President Ramaphosa?
I have not yet.
But you hope to soon.
I hope to soon. I'm greatly looking forward to it. Greatly looking forward to it. I feel like I already know him and we haven't even met.
That's quite concerning. You seem to know the president already, but you've never met him. And also, you are one of the most strategic partners that we need to have. And it's been 4 months now and the president still hasn't met with you. That tells you everything you need to know about how much he respects the United States relations, and specifically you, Lana, as to how much respect he has for you being the representative for the United States in South Africa.
Ambassador, in August 2018, President Trump tweeted that he is very concerned about not only the possibility of what he called land grabs in South Africa, but also the murder of South African farmers, and he asked Secretary Mike Pompeo to investigate. We've been asked by some viewers to ask you tonight whether there's been any progress in that investigation.
You know, farm murders are shocking and unacceptable. All murders in South Africa are shocking and unacceptable. All I can say is that the process is being dealt with in a very transparent manner again, as are other matters, and so far so good.
You see, this is what really pisses me off, is when you put people in positions that don't have a cooking clue as to what's going on in this country. She says that it's being dealt with in a transparent manner. I'm sure that is what they probably wrote down for it. Just put in as many times as you can, things are being dealt with in a transparent manner, just to keep the peace. But that's bullshit. Because Cyril Ramaphosa has come out and denied that farm murders are actually taking place in this country.
But on the tweet itself, he was clearly misinformed. And whoever gave him that information was completely wrong. There are no killings of farmers or white farmers in South Africa.
So how exactly is he being transparent when he doesn't even acknowledge a specific crime taking place in South Africa? We've got 59 murders a day in this country. There are various farm murders that take place that the president is denying of taking place. And you want to say that everything is being dealt with in an open and transparent manner? Please go and sell that bullshit someplace else, because it's not going to work here.
The only thing I can say is that I'm the only ambassador that's ever been appointed for the United States to South Africa who's entirely from private industry. So the way now we go about things is to get to the bottom line, to do a deal, to increase trade dramatically. I'm not previously from government. I'm not a civil servant. So perhaps I'm somebody who likes to get things done.
Yes, there's no doubt that you don't have any political experience, because you are so easily fooled by what the government is saying and you're just blindly taking their word for this. This isn't the private industry where you can actually shake hands and believe that that deal will go through. In government, we know that it's all about lying, manipulating the statistics in order to suit your narrative. And the fact that you are blindly falling for it is really problematic. And added to this, I see that when they interviewed you for this position, you stated that you can speak three languages fluently: English, Afrikaans, and isiXhosa. Now, I call bullshit. I don't think that you can speak Afrikaans fluently, and definitely you can't speak isiXhosa at all. And this is quite interesting, because this is something that you stated in your interview in the United States, that you can speak those three languages. So I call bullshit on two of those languages that you can speak fluently according to you. And I call on to you to prove that you can speak isiXhosa and Afrikaans fluently. So to end off this video, unfortunately, it seems that the US-South African relations aren't going to be honest with one another. Because here we have an individual that is very gullible and just wants to believe that everything is awesome and rosy and South Africa has got an amazing future ahead of it. And on the other hand, you've got Cyril Ramaphosa and his cronies that's going to bullshit this poor woman into believing that everything is fine. And she seems gullible enough to fall for all of it. Especially if you look at this interview and what she said to Valdemar with regards to how optimistic she is about South Africa. Then added to all of this, the fact that she doesn't really know what's going on in South Africa and what the president has said in the past, as well as the policies that they want to implement. EWC and the NHI will destroy this country, and she's optimistic that she's going to improve the trade relations between the two countries. How the hell can you do that if one of the two countries are heading straight into a recession and junk status? It's just not possible. And that's basically all I've got to say. If you enjoy my content, then please consider becoming a member. You can do so by clicking the join button below. Also, please be sure to subscribe. And if you are subscribed, hit that bell icon so you can be notified of my future uploads. Also, please be sure to drop a comment. Let me know what you think, as well as smashing the like button. Let's see if we can get 1,111 likes, and that would hopefully make Lana take notice of the bullshit that she's being fed by the government in South Africa. Lastly, please be sure to share this video with your friends and family, because that's literally the only way my message gets out there. Till later, cheers and peace out.